Our text comments contain this thought. If you look about halfway down, there's a sentence that says, feeling tender compassion will move us to acts of kindness. It's interesting, the Bible in different places links those two qualities together. For example, Ephesians 4:32 states, become kind to one another, tenderly compassionate. Insight on the Scriptures defines compassion this way. It's a sympathetic awareness of another's suffering or adversity, coupled with a desire to alleviate it. So we have the awareness, we have the feeling, along with that desire to act kindly. But sadly, as the Watchtower once mentioned, the moral climate of our time has killed compassion in the hearts of so many.
And I just told them, look, I just can't let my child die in that way. And the elders were just so upset, they left. In a huff, they were mad. And one of the elders said on the way out, he looked me in the eye and said, you know what? I hope your daughter gets hepatitis from that blood. And that was just the straw that broke the camel's back. I was just broken here, my own people, God's organization, turning against me, cursing me, because I just wanted to see my child live.
So Jehovah wasn't blind to the misery of his people. He wasn't deaf to their cries for help. Their anguish became his own. Did you notice the expression at the end of the verse? I well know the pains they suffer.
Because of the way that they had treated my family, I disassociated myself from the Watchtower Society, never dreaming that my children would refuse to have anything to do with me. In fact, I have a little 2-year-old grandson that I've never even seen.
My 2 children and my 5 grandchildren are forbidden to see me, their grandmother, because of the Watchtower. What kind of organization, going under the heading of Christian, would disallow the children and grandchildren to see their mother and grandmother?
Every person will recognize the Watchtower's practice of shunning as a cold, unloving, evil thing.
First, you know, there are times when compassion should not be shown.
The lives of the disfellowshipped are filled with the chill of loneliness, the never-ending sadness of separation from family members. To find something to believe in, to trust in, is very hard.
After I'd ran across some literature that exposed their false prophecies and their deceitful ways of covering up, I then was able to realize that they weren't God's organization, and I was able to search for God. And I found Jesus Christ, and he is my personal savior, and he's changed my life just 100%.
The apostates and the enemies of Jehovah and all these despicable enemies, especially these despicable apostates who at one point had dedicated their life to God, and then they joined forces with Satan, the devil, the chief apostate of all time.
First, compassion will help us to avoid reacting harshly when others make mistakes. Remember earlier we quoted Ephesians 4:32, linking kindness and compassion?
May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.